that he will not play any competitive darts next year. So
never say never.
No, when we've got to, you know, accept and respect his decision. Yeah. Been a great ambassador for the game, and a great player.
His last tournament victory, Champions League darts, way back in September of last year. 81. So the children from the Shanghai Darts Training Academy. Yeah, great honour for Hyun Chul Park to represent his country here in Shanghai. What a big moment as well to be playing Philip Taylor. 100. For those who perhaps don't know, explain the main differences between playing steel tip darts and soft tip darts. Of course, soft tip huge over this part of the globe.
Well, soft tip is an electronic dartboard. You actually pay to have to play, and they've really have got it off into a fine business throughout Asia. The point is actually plastic. And it goes into a honeycomb dartboard, and the dartboard's completely electronic, so whatever you hit automatically takes it off your score, so you don't have to count. That's why sometimes you'll see what we call the soft dip players miscount or have to step back because they're not used to having to do it in their own head. But all these electronic dartboards are all live stream now, so you've got a big screen above them, so you can actually play someone in Australia. And they have got an incredible business. It's a huge industry. Very financial as well. But the shape of the dart, the weight of the dart, not a lot of difference.
The bull is used a lot more, isn't it, in soft tip as well?
Yeah, there's two different types. You have the American side of things where the doubles and trebles are all twice the size and there's just one bullseye. But they do play on the bullseye. The 501 game is played on the bullseye. I've played a few players here years ago. I'm going for treble 20s and thinking, what are they doing on the bullseyes? And of course, when you lose, you realise why they're going for the bullseyes.
But Park, very successful in soft tip. Lost a grand final last year to Boris Krishmar, who was seen in PDC events as well. Yep, first dart and a double, and it goes, and Taylor takes the opening leg against the darts. You may remember, Rob, one of the most remarkable games that we've seen in World Series darts history was actually here in Shanghai 12 months ago and featured this man, Phil Taylor, who finds the first maximum. In the quarterfinals, 7-1 down to Peter Wright and 1-8-7.
Yes, I do remember it well, and it hurt Peter Wright. He couldn't believe what had happened. The problem is, when you're going 7-1 up, you think, I only need one more leg, and you kind of lose your concentration. You lose that little bit of adrenaline thinking, I'll just get over the line. Then all of a sudden, you know, it's 7-2, and you think, well, I've still got plenty of time. Then it's 7-3 as we see Phil Taylor. That's number 5. Oh, and it's caught the flight and deflected in the 5.
Well, Phil Taylor's still the only man to hit a 9-darter in World Series history.
Yes, in Sydney.
Yep, 2015. 41. 50 televised 9-darters to date.
He went on to beat Michael van Gerwen there, I believe, as well, Stuart. Check your stats.
100. And I've darted Kane against Peter Wright. The tournament win came against Michael van Gerwen.
Yeah, van Gerwen, remember it very well. Well, we remember all those because we were commentating on them. Well, Phil Taylor, the first player this evening so far to have over the 100 average, up at 108 at the moment. 60. I know we're only just into the second leg, but it's better to start off there because it's easier to maintain it than start off with a low 80s.
56.
So Parku won the Korean qualifier in some style. Well, this is some style as well. Unlucky, not to get a full house. Taylor looking at tops for 2-0.
Game shot.
Bill Taylor still just one leg, one victory, I should say, behind Michael van Gerwen in the World Series Roll of Honour. Van Gerwen winning 8 World Series titles, including both World Series finals in Scotland. Taylor's won 7, Gary Anderson 4, and Adrian Lewis 1. Still only 4 men have won World Series events, going all the way back to that first one in Dubai over 4 years ago.
58.
What's the motivation now for Taylor for the rest of the year to win one more big one?
Possibly just to put it in the face of the other players. He hasn't got to prove anything to anybody else. You know, all the talk for the last 2 or 3 years has been about Van Gerwen, how he's playing, you know, when he's shooting those incredible averages, 123, and Gary Anderson, the way he's playing, and Peter Wright's coming through the ranks very quickly. He hasn't got to prove to anybody by winning another tournament. I think it's just to say to them, you know, I've been around a long time, I'm still around, and I'm still tough to beat.
So used to winning, Phil Taylor, that the last couple of years for Taylor must have been difficult because he's had to get used to losing.
Yes, and that's been hard. He's been so used to dominating the game and everybody talking about him. Now, you know, we've got other stars that are coming in, so obviously you're talking about everybody else as well. And that's what every top sportsman is like in any sport. They're all the same. Well, that's 2. Can he hit the 180 this time? And he's got a little bit excited and overpitched.
Enjoying himself, though. He's got a great chance here to win a leg against Phil Taylor.
100.
Well, he's going to get 6 stars from here. So if he doesn't take it out, just don't miss any numbers and just leave the 3 darts at the double when you come back.
Frustration for Taylor.
52.
15 darts already in this leg for Taylor. So a great chance for the Korean.
28.
A massive chance missed.
It's
a big shot out.
The pressure as well.
Yes, and how many times have we seen Phil Taylor do this? Triple 18 will leave him a dart at the bullseye. However, Park will come back.
56.
Another 3 darts at the double.
To win a leg against the greatest darts player there has ever been.
For
the moment, he will remember forever and a day, forever in his darting day. What a feeling that is to win a leg against Phil Taylor. And well, he's in the match now as Taylor strikes back.
139.
Well, it should give the young man a bit more confidence now that he's taken that one leg. Well, look at that dart. That's exactly what it's done.
85.
Just a little bit too much body movement with that third dart. We talk about it a lot, Stuart, don't we, with different players. You know, you've got to keep that body still. Look at Phil Taylor's. It does not move. The torso does not move at all. Well, that's his second maximum of this match. If you've got body movement, it's extremely hard to get ultra consistent.
Not what he was hoping for, but he still left at 17 after just 9 darts. Double 8 for Taylor.
Game seven.
A darter that will do. A different leg. Leg 3, but that was much more like it from Taylor.
Yes, a very tidy 12 dart leg there from Taylor.
16.
Good opening night crowd in Shanghai.
Yes, we went and done one of the links down on the Bund today, which is the financial district there, and it's quite a sight looking across the river to all the high-rise buildings. And how colourful they make the buildings over here. It isn't just a blank grey building. There's reds and there's multicolours. It really looks great in the evening time. Bit like Peter Wright's hairdo, really. Not quite as tall as Peter Wright's hairdo, but...
Good city. Great city, actually.
And don't forget, I said about Peter Wright this evening. Very interesting concept he's using tonight. Explained it to me, and it makes sense. In a way.
Yeah, as much as anything that Peter Wright does all say can make sense.
45.
But he does have some huge followers over here in the Far East. They love the coloured hair. They love what he's made him himself into. And I know a lot of youngsters back home follow Peter Wright because of how colourful he is.
Well, you remember back to the 2 years that we spent in Japan, in Yokohama and Tokyo. I mean, half the crowd turned up in Peter Wright wigs, didn't they? Massive star over there.
Yes, and I know a young 12-year-old that grandmother lives just opposite me, Daniel. I know he'll be watching Peter Wright later on. Bullseye now for Phil Taylor, and he will go for just north of the red bit.
Loves a showpiece finish. Wanted to give the crowd a showpiece finish as well. Have to settle for 9 and double 8 instead. 100 average, Taylor.
60. Will we require 25? Game shown the football.
It's as good as the bullseye. Six as long as you're winning the leg. First.
Game on.
Yes, another break of throw with a 14 dart leg.
Still to come on the opening night. Dave Chisnall, Peter Wright, and then Michael Van Gerwen and Gary Anderson.
Well, a tough game for Chizzy against Paul Lim.
Yep.
You know, Paul Lim, as we see in the World Cup, played exceptional. And has been a great player played in the very first match plays and World Championships of the PDC.
60.
And the first man to hit a nine darter live on TV, way back in the early days of Lakeside.
Well, Madam Fulton.
Steady tons won't come close to challenging Phil Taylor. Go back to what you said before about the throwing action and the style and jumping into the throw. I guess when you get to this stage, though, and you've been playing for that long, it's very, very difficult to change because the throw just comes naturally, doesn't it? It is what it is.
Yes, if you started off with a throw, say, like Parks, where he pulls his head back on release, and if it's been like that from day one, then it's very hard to change. But it's players that have had a good solid throw and then just get little things that come into the throw. They're the ones that actually can change it back.
Double 19.
16.
Well, depending on what Park scores here, Taylor may well look at splitting this. Has options. As he looks to go within one leg of the quarterfinals. Going straight for it. Yep, game there we go. Third time lucky. 5-1 it is.
Yes, and still over the 100 average. 101.31. And Phil Taylor would love to just put a statement out there of being the first player this evening to have over the 100 average. And it just sends out a message to it, doesn't it? That's what I would do.
41.
Puts a little bit of pressure on the next four PDC players to try and beat it anyway.
And they'll all want to, you can be sure
of that.
Oh, yes,
especially Van Gerwen and Anderson. The amount of times that Parker's put a great first dart and then not followed it up. And against Phil Taylor, you can't do that. 2 180s, 6 140s. Never been a prolific 180 hitter, Phil Taylor, but certainly the 140s and using that treble 19 after two treble 20s.
Well, Taylor's last World Series triumph in Sydney last year. And that's his only final, actually, in the World Series since he won Sydney back in 2015.
He was unbeaten for quite a while in Australia, wasn't he?
Yeah, I remember in Australia last year when he was beaten by the young Aussie sensation Corey Cadby.
That was a great performance, wasn't it? Is he finally going to hit a maximum? Oh, wow, and again, he just got a bit too excited.
Come on, Mr. Park! Square!
Can he win it in style? Go. Of course he can. Phil Taylor with 121 shot on the ball. An average of 104 and smiles in Shanghai for Philip Taylor's. He just sends out a little message that he's still very much in the mix to win the big tournament. He's in with a shout in the World Series. He may well be playing Michael Van Gerwen in the quarterfinals. And coming up next, it's the grand old man of Asian darts, the wonderful Paul Lim. And he will take on Dave Chisnall here in Shanghai.